I heard about Iceland is that it's really expensive. And to some extent, it's true. And one of the things you need to consider when you're planning a trip is how much you'll be spending day by day. So in this video, I'm gonna break down how much I spent and some of the places that you could either cut costs or spend a little more. So first, we'll talk about lodging. My go-to almost everywhere in the world is hostels. So for a hostel, you can get about $30 a night in Iceland. It's nice, it's clean, it's a great place to meet travelers. If you really want to save money, you could try couch surfing, which is free. I had some friends that had some bad experiences with that, so I wouldn't suggest it. And then, of course, you have the really nice hotels, which range from $150 plus. But my suggestion, hostels. So then let's talk about food. Food, there's a broad range of how much you could spend on food. So at minimum, there are a few days I went to the grocery store, bought a box of pasta, cooked the pasta at my hostel on the stove with their silverware or their pots, and that's like $4 for the entire day. Kind of in between is going to some lower cost restaurants if you want to try like fish shawarma or like some of the cool stuff. They have like an unlimited buffet of soup as a restaurant, and then you know the hot dogs. That's probably around $10 to $15. Each hot dog was $3 to $4. And then, of course, you have the more expensive, fancy restaurants. You know, you're talking like $30 plus. And if you want to do nightlife, so nightlife can be very expensive in Iceland. Everywhere we went, each beer was maybe $7 to $8, like beer on tap. And, you know, cocktails were even more. So if you're going to Iceland, buy alcohol at the duty-free at the airport. So like I was saying, one glass of beer is like $8. You can get a whole bottle of alcohol, like vodka, rum, for like $15. For like a decent quality, decent sized bottle. And then you can just pregame at your hostel. It's a great way to meet new friends. And then so the third is transportation. So back to the bare minimum. Once you get to Reykjavik, you can walk around most of Reykjavik for free. But Iceland, you'd be missing out if you didn't leave Reykjavik. So to get to the Golden Circle, to get to the southern coast, that's all either a tour bus or a rental car. And I told myself that I was not going to go to Iceland as a solo traveler unless I could get someone to share a rental car with, because it's just so expensive. So each day was maybe $10 to $15 in split gas and to help pay for the rental car. One time I was going to, my friend was in the rental car and he wanted to keep going, but I had to go back to Reykjavik to get to the airport, so my backup was to take the public bus. You can take the public bus, but it's almost like $50 one way. But we ran into these females from France who were driving back to Reykjavik, and they just let me hitchhike in their car. I offered to pay for gas, they said no. So those are, you know, your necessities, your food, transportation, lodging. You might have seen in the other videos, some of the extras was like the Blue Lagoon. If you didn't get a rental car and did guided tours, those can be $80 and up. To recap, bare minimum, you stay at hostels, you only eat food from the grocery store that you cook, and you don't really go outside of Reykjavik. You're talking like $35 a day. A little more, meaning you stay at hostels, but you go out to eat on occasion, you drink, you do some of the nightlife, and you leave Reykjavik to the surrounding areas via rental car. Then you're talking maybe $50-$60 a day, if you're cheap about it. Maximum, you know, like crazy fancy living, you're talking a hotel, nice food, guided tours. You're talking maybe $300 a day, you know, upwards. And so all of this, you have to also add your flights and just the transportation from the airport to downtown. So honestly, caveat to this whole thing is I went to Iceland because I had a gift card. So a while ago when I was traveling back from Pakistan, I had a layover in Iceland and my flight got delayed. So they gave me a $900 gift card. I used the gift card to have a free flight. Then I sold the rest of my gift card to a friend so he can have free flights, you know, like all that. And made back pretty much everything that I spent. So, like I said before, that was a lot of information, really, really quick. But thanks for listening, and check back next week for another video.